Happy morning, dear friends. Here's yours, Dr. Rajanta. Welcome to Demystify with Agile. Today we are in the first tutorial of Data Science and Machine Learning series. In last challenge, when I'm just making my Python 60-60-60 challenge, there were so many of queries is that related to the installation of Python, because so many are having a confusion whether to go on PyCharm or Jupyter. Because my whole session was with the Jupyter Notebook. And here is the exact solution is there, dear friends. See, actually, PyCharm and Jupyter are two very popular environments among Python developers and data scientists. Both these environments offer their own set of advantages. But which between the two should a data scientist pick? In short, Jupyter is more suitable option when you have quick data processing and visualization task at hand. In other words, Jupyter can be great as a rapid prototyping and visualization tool. When coming to the PyCharm, it is the most suited for complex data processing. Think about the scenario where you are dealing with large and dynamic data sets that require long-term analysis. Or you will want to develop a complex application for this, and PyCharm is much better at handling this. And as a professional data scientist, there will be plenty of instances where you will have to build a complex data analytics tool. There will also be plenty of instances where you will be required to do a quick analysis and data visualization. So thus, both Jupyter and PyCharm will have their use cases. If you are looking to work as an entry-level data scientist, you can go ahead and start off by learning Jupyter. Because Jupyter offers interactive outputs, meaning you can write your code and then test it within the same interface. This is very helpful feature for beginners. So the overall interface is also easier to work with, featuring all the tools you will need as a data scientist under the same work environment. So hence, I have used the Jupyter Notebook as the base. And here I have just provided you the three options of installation, how you can just go ahead and kindly follow the instruction one by one without missing any set of options. Okay. We are just going to see in three ways, that is three options. One, directly installing the Python of latest version. Second, installing Anaconda, where using Jupyter Notebook, you are just going to code Python. Third option is using online Python compiler. Let me just go for the first option, installation of Python latest version. Further, we need to go for the official website, python.org. Click on to download section. Here you will get the latest version. Just click on the download Python 3.10.4. Simply download the version it shows. Keep it in mind that here it always shows you the latest version of Python at the top. After downloading the file, we will get an executable file like this. Simply double click onto the file. An install wizard will open. Click on to add path, make it enable. Even though install now is the exact option, let me just go for the customize installation. And check, make sure to check all the boxes like this. Then click on next. Then you will see this screen, that is advanced option. If you want then you can click all the boxes. I do not need the debug symbol and the debug binaries. So apart from that, I just click all the options. Check for the path. I would also recommend that you not change the location of the installation. Remember the install location, as you might need that later. We are adding Python to the environmental variable here directly. So then click install. Let the installation process finish up. If you get this type of prompt to disable the path length limit, then simply click on to that box. So it disables the path length limit by removing the limitation on the max path variable. This change will not break anything or make any negative changes. It will just allow Python to use long path name. It will recommend to disable the path length limit. Let us just wait for a few more seconds. Here, the installation has been finished successfully. How to check the Python version that has been installed? Let me just open the command window or PowerShell. We need to apply the command Python hyphen hyphen version. Yeah. So we have been installed and the path has also been added in the environment variable successfully. Okay, let me just check for few more commands. So here it is the Python prompt. Let me just give the basic print function. Here we are. We can also check or make use of IDLE prompt. Let me just click on to IDLE. Here also the same basic command. Let me just give the yeah, you can make use of this, or else we can use an editor. Okay. We have to save before executing. So the default path that I just give the file to be saved. Okay, let I execute it. Here it's. So this is how you can just make use of the Python by installing it in latest version. Okay, let me just go for the second option by installing Anaconda. The Anaconda is an open source software that contains Jupyter, Spider, etc. that are used for large data processing, data analytics, heavy scientific computing. Anaconda works for R and Python programming language. So packages versions are managed by the package management system Conda. Now let me just see how to install Anaconda. So for that you have to just go for the official page of this Anaconda website and just click on to the download. See here, we are just having 64-bit as a default. We have to wait for a while. Once the download done, locate your download and double click it. Okay, the screen would appear. Click on to next. Read the license agreement and click on to I agree. Here it just provide the installation. Let me just make the recommended. Note your installation location and then click on to next. This is an important part of installation process. The recommended approach is to not check the box to add Anaconda to your path. This means you will have to use Anaconda Navigator or the Anaconda command prompt. When you wish to use Anaconda to the path, if you want, you're able to use in the command, your command prompt. Please use the alternate. Alternate is that you have to check this. So let me just make on to that recommended approach and click on to install. It just get only few seconds to finish the setting up the package. Once the installation completed, click on to next. And the setup is completed. You can open the Anaconda by using Navigator. Navigator, this screen would be seen. You can just launch Jupyter Notebook. And here it just takes to our page, that is localhost. And for your information, I have already have some Python file. Anyhow, let I just create a new Python file by clicking new and Python 3. Here it is opening the new Jupyter Notebook. And here once on clicking run, it is executed. So here how you can just use Anaconda through Jupyter Notebook. You can code on Python. Here is the third option. You can use any online Python compiler. Here it is my suggestion, just clicking on to onlinegdb.com, which is one among the online Python compiler. You can also provide the same print command here, and on executing by clicking the run, you will receive the output. Even you can just type any other code. And just execute by clicking run. Here is the output. So dear friends, here we have just seen the three options for installing Python. So far we have discussed different ways to install Python and how to run code using Python by native interactive cells. For long-term storage, you can save content to Python file or .py file, and you can edit or execute them as scripts or programs. However, the method discussed here are sufficient for getting started. In this session, we installed Python on your machine, installed a text editor, and tried a few commands. All right, friends, this is where the second day sessions comes to an end. I hope you have enjoyed this post. Hope this video was useful to you. Give a thumbs up and subscribe. I will see you in the next video. Thank you.